Hello everyone, and welcome to another of our online assemblies. We're thinking about waiting today. This is a bit of a waiting time, and I bet some of you are waiting for advent calendars, which are going to be starting soon. I expect to be opening on the 1st of December. We're all waiting for things, and that's what I want us to think about today for a bit. So if you've got somebody else with you, and if you've got a candle, you might like to light it. And we begin our assembly by saying, Jesus, the light of the world is here. Lord Jesus, shine on us. Now, when you're in school, you probably do quite a lot of waiting in line, perhaps in other places too. And waiting in line, we're queuing. I wonder what these children are waiting for. They might be waiting to go to assembly. They might be waiting to go to lunch. They might be waiting to go home. But they're certainly waiting for something. We spend quite a lot of our time in our lives waiting. If we were going to catch this bus, we might have to look at the bus timetable. We might have to go to a bus stop. We'd be waiting for the bus to come along so that we can catch the bus. Another time when we're waiting is when we're shopping. And you'll see the chap at the back of the queue here. He's getting a bit impatient with his waiting. He wants to get on with whatever else he's doing this day. So we're waiting in line for shopping. We might have to wait at the post office if we want to post a letter. Lots of people are getting things ready for Christmas, getting cards ready. You might need to post that. They have to queue at the post office. Not necessarily waiting in line, but another bit of waiting is when you're waiting for a new baby to come. And everyone gets very excited. And we're quite excited at the moment because this is Rose, my new granddaughter, who is 4 weeks old and is absolutely lovely. But there was a lot of waiting and a lot of excitement as we waited for her to come. And the first part of the Bible, the Old Testament, is waiting for something. It's waiting. The prophets were looking forward and hoping that something would happen. And what they were waiting for was Jesus to come. And that's when we're doing Advent, when we're looking towards Christmas, when we're opening our Advent calendars, that's what it's all about. It's building up the excitement as we're waiting for Jesus to come at Christmas. I mentioned that word, Advent. Advent begins, it began on Sunday the 29th. Some people don't open the calendars to the 1st, but Advent actually began on the 29th. It's 4 Sundays before Christmas. And Advent comes from a Latin word, adventiri, which is talking about coming. So when we talk about Advent, we're just talking about coming. We're waiting for someone to come. We're waiting for Jesus to come into the world. That's what we celebrate at Christmas. And these 4 weeks of Advent are looking forward and waiting and getting excited about that happening. So Advent is coming. It means coming. It means looking forward. And it fits to this other word as well. It comes from the same place, an adventure. And if you think of it, an adventure is when you're going to do something that's coming. You're going to climb a mountain, or you're going to go on an expedition, or you're going to go and do something really exciting. And that's where Advent of the Advent and the adventure. Now, one of the things that we're going to do this Advent, we've done it other times as well, is Posada. Posada's a Mexican or South American word for inn. In this case, it's the inn where Jesus and Mary couldn't find any room. And you'll see here, these children and adults are actually dressed up as Mary and Joseph and going round. But we're going to do it in an online way this year, because we can't hand round the Mary and Joseph figures, which usually go around the school classrooms and all over the place. But if you go to our Avon Valley Church's website, you will be able to look up Posada, and you'll be able to sign up, and you'll be able to, on an online way, have Mary and Joseph come to stay with you for a night as we wait for Christmas. So that's part of our Advent waiting and our Advent adventure. So you could make your own Advent adventure. What would you like to do in these 4 weeks as you get ready for Christmas? Is there something really positive you could do? Could you change something in your own life as you wait for Christmas to come? It might be learning to think about other people more. It might be deciding to do something helpful around the house. It might be deciding to read a Bible story each day, or to spend a few minutes just saying thank you to God for the really good things that you've got in your life. It's up to you. Whatever you decide, you can choose as your Advent adventure. And if you've got an Advent calendar, you've opened that each day, perhaps that can remind you of the Advent adventure that we're on and what we're waiting for. Advent is waiting for the coming of Jesus at Christmas. So a few moments just to think about what you've heard. What might your Advent adventure be? Jesus, we thank you for your coming into the world at Christmas. We thank you for all the excitement as we get ready for Christmas. And as we look forward to Christmas, help us on our own Advent adventure as we walk with you on this journey. Amen. If your school has a prayer, you might like to pause the video and say that school prayer. That's the first line for Bremer and Hyde School. And then we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
From the darkness came light, from the blackest of nights. Wait for the morning, the sunlight, the dawning. From the darkness came light, earth so dark and so cold. What great secrets you hold, the promise of spring, the wonder you bring, the beauty of nature unfold. From the darkness came light, from the blackest of nights. Wait for the morning, the sunlight, the dawning. From the darkness came light. Jesus was born in a stall, known to bring light to us all. He came to love us, a new life to give us. Jesus was born in a stall. From the darkness came light, from the blackest of nights. Wait for the morning, the sunlight, the dawning. From the darkness came light. We have this new life to share, a love to pass on everywhere. Time spent in giving, a joy in our living, in showing to others we care. From the darkness came light, from the blackest of nights. Wait for the morning, the sunlight, the dawning. From the darkness came light, from the darkness came light. From the blackest of nights. Wait for the morning, the sunlight, the dawning. From the darkness came, from the darkness came, from the darkness came light.
It's something about waiting. This is an advert from John Lewis from a few years ago now, and I think it's just such a super helping to help us think about waiting for Christmas.
Good times for a change. See the luck I've had, could make a good man turn bad. So for once in my life, let me get what I want. Lord knows it would be the first time. Time.
Now, other stores are available, as well as John Lewis. But it just was really good, that thing. That we all think that he's desperate to get to Christmas because he wants his presents. And what he's really trying to do is to give a present to his parents. I think it's really very touching. Well, I hope you have a really good Advent. I hope you have a really good Christmas, but I'm hoping to see you before then. So we go from here to rejoice in the Father's love, to walk in Jesus' light, and to reflect the Spirit's glory. Amen. And I hope you have a wonderful Advent and a great Advent adventure. See you soon.